One more, maybe?
还能再问一个吗?
Okay.
Okay, one more.
I'd like to hear your definition of truth.
这个真相呢，就是说来就那种比较多，就我们这个信的这种真相，就到最后是真的是，就也不是有的东西，也不是无的东西，就是就像虚空一样的空。但是这个空呢，也是带着这种光明的。就是一旦我们认识了这样的境界的话呢，就是这个也可以叫真相。然后我们这个万事万物呢，就是它最后真正去观察的时候呢。就像现在物理学家所讲到的那种这个最后的一种能量场，但最后那个也不存在，然后这种空呢也并不是是真相，所以这是跟可能是这个真相的这个层次呢，就是有很多层次，就是到最后呢就可以说是不可思议，就不可言说，就是这个是按照我们的很多观点来讲是可以叫做是真相，就是什么时候把这个这样的真相通达的话，我们叫做是开悟。
Truth is a vast topic. It's a very vast topic. But how we describe truth, we can describe it in terms of our mind, the truth of our mind. The truth or the nature of our mind is neither existent nor non-existent. It is just like the space that we perceive, or it's like the vast space or vast sky. It is spacious at the same time luminous. In science we talk about phenomena could be directed to smaller particles, and eventually that is only left with energy field. But at the end, in Buddhism, we talk about that energy field is not even existent. But at the same time, while it's not existent, it is not void, it's not nothingness. So that is the truth. That is the truth that has, in fact, there are many levels in it. There are many levels of realizing it. That truth is not really speakable. You cannot use words to describe it. You cannot think of it through your conceptual mind. But once you really see it, once you really realize that truth, we can call that enlightenment.
So I think those were pretty good closing words.
我觉得那个是一个特别圆满的结尾。
So please join me in thanking Kenpo Sotake Rinpoche.
一起感谢堪布。
And let me just say that whoever wants another taste of Kenpo Laso, then we'll be lighting candles in the afternoon at 4:05 here in Gusheva. So everybody's welcome. And there may even be enough sufganiyot for everyone.